Hi, we are going to talk about hydrogenation reactions. These are going to be alkenes that we add hydrogen to, and it's going to make an alkane. Long and short of it, what we're doing really is saturating the alkenes to make them alkanes. So in this addition reaction, let's break it down. You're going to have your alkene, that double bond, and the double bond, we're going to break one bond inside of that. Break one bond in the double bond when we add the hydrogen to it. And then the hydrogen is going to form two single bonds, two single bonds. So you're going from the alkene to the alkane. Now, something really important, we have to use a metal catalyst. An example of that would be palladium. So make sure that you have memorized with your hydrogenation reactions. Again, this is the type of alkene addition reaction that you have to have that metal catalyst. Put that on your note card, your flashcard, so that you can memorize these. I have three examples for you. Let's first begin with a 1-butene. So there's my double bond. We add the hydrogen. I've got my metal catalyst. And now, so I broke it out so you can see it explicitly. That double bond, that second bond, breaks, becomes a single bond, and the two hydrogens are now added. So how we would write this in our condensed form, it would just become butene, CH3, CH2, CH2, right there, there's my CH2, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, CH2, sorry, and then my CH3, nice. Right in between there, we added a hydrogen, nice. Let's look in a skeletal structure example. So here I'd have a 1, 2, 3, I'd have a 3-hexene, okay, 3-hexene. We add our hydrogen to that alkene. We've got the metal catalyst with it. And how I'd write it? I just make that a single bond because a hydrogen was added here and a hydrogen was added there. And we know when we write our skeletal structures that we always fill in enough hydrogens to give every carbon a total of 4 bonds. So then I just draw this as hexane. It went from that unsaturated to saturated. That double bond is broken, we add the two hydrogens, and we've got the alkane, which is saturated, maximum number of hydrogens around those carbons. Let's do a 1-methylcyclohexene, okay? So I'm going to add the hydrogen. Now, sometimes that little methyl group throws students. Don't let it throw you. We're just adding both hydrogens to break that double bond. So I wrote it out for you so you could see it explicitly. We've got the methyl group, there's the hydrogen that was added, the second hydrogen that was added, so that broke that double bond, we added those two, and then there's the hydrogen that was already there. So how would I draw this? I would just draw the methyl cyclohexane. Take out that double bond and it's understood there's another hydrogen and another hydrogen right there. Nice. So hydrogenation, you'll hear this. People talking maybe about margarine that is hydrogenated or peanut butter has been hydrogenated. We've just added the hydrogen to it to break those double bonds, make single bonds, so we have a saturated alkane. Not as healthy for us. Avoid foods that have been hydrogenated. But there you have it. Good work. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.